Yale ambazo mmeona kuhusu state, kuhusu maandamano Kenya, please sio mchezo. Lakini ujinga ni kwamba serikali hii itadhani mzaha. Na watu wengine watadhani ni mchezo, so watakuwa na mchezo na mzaha. Terrible. In case the Ruto administration and the trigger happy policemen and the ignorant police force make a mistake of shedding blood, Kenya itakuwa mbaya sana. And hizi maandamano zitaendelea na zitaendelea, itafika mahali kaifike. That's the message I have from God. So, watu mjipange. I saw katika ufunuo hizi, State House ya Kenya. Okay, niseme generally hivi, kuna ndoto nyingi na ufunuo nyingi ambazo watu pia unazipata. Na I don't think I'm the only one that is seeing them. Ukuta ya State House kuanguka. Fence ya State House kuanguka. Kuona State House iko na giza. Kuona maji ya sewage inatoka State House. Kuona ndani ya State House kuna maeneo ambamo ni kuchafu sana. Kuona ndani ya State House kuna inzi. Kuona ndani ya State House kuna uozo. This such, if you are having such dreams, what God is saying is that things are bad and that there is no God. There is no God's blessing in State House. Inaonyesha kwamba mkono wa Mungu wenye baraka haimo juu ya serikali hii. Na ikulu vile vile haina kibali ya Mungu. Ukiona ndoto kama hizo. Kisha ukiona pia ndoto ama ufunuo kuhusu yale ambazo pia mimi nikawa nimepewa. State House ya Kenya imepigwa na radi ama inafanyishwa mtetemeko. So if you know, like I've had visions and visions about earthquakes or tremor and lightning and thunder by na piga State House, by na piga State House, by na nguruma jia State House, nguruma wa radi, thunderbolts, and the voice of tremor over State House. It shows that Mungu amekasirika. Na lazima the striking of State House na lightning, lazima itamalizia na maafa, itamalizia na mauti. God expresses his anger. Mungu anaonyesha ghadhabu zake. Katika hali za utasikia mtetemeko, mngurumo, na pia mngurumo wa radi. So wakati Mungu anafanya mambo kama hayo, anaonyesha mambo kama hayo, basi ni ghadhabu zake Mungu. Wewe ambaye unampenda, unashikilia imani, ogopa sana. But mambo haya yanafanyika hadi pale the current captain itafika mahali penye mwenyewe akubali. Maana katika mmoja wapo wa hizo ufunuo zilimshtua, alishtuka, akakamatwa na hofu. What is going on? Na such might even send him to reside outside State House. Mana, God is not going to stop. By the time God acts, his final stroke, he will have warned and warned over and over again to Captain Ruto. God in his love, he never destroys, he never judges anybody without warnings. Mungu huwa hukumu mtu pasipo kwanza kumpea maonyo mengi, maonyo. Nabi Yona alitumwa Nineve, akapeana maonyo kwamba Mungu ataangamiza Nineve. Alipeana maonyo kwa siku 40 mfululizo. Every day Jonah will wake up and say the same words of warning about the same theme, God's judgment. You try that one. Jaribu uongee maonyo kuhusu hali moja. Rudia kwa siku 40. Bwana asema, tubuni hapa, maana mimi Mungu nitaua mtu. Mungu asema, enyi watu tubuni, maana Mungu anasema atawaangamiza. Jonah alifanya hiyo for 40 days, siku 40. Anaona baada ya hapo alikasirika. Sema Mungu ulifikiri baada ya mimi kufanya kazi hivyo utaua mtu. Mungu hakuua. So Jonah akasema, hii biashara ya unabii hata mimi sipendi, na akaenda kaa chini ya mti. Na I think that was the last prophecy alipeana. After that we don't hear about him. He's always to give prophecy. Na ndio watu ambao wanalinga na maneno na mdomo. Chungeni. I can wake up one day like Jonah and say simukufe. I wonder about three leaders in the Kalenjin land. One from South Rift, one from Central Rift, and another one from North Rift. Picha yangu ni mzuri, please. Nikasema midomo yao itaongea mambo ambazo ni za ajabu ajabu, bazo ni matusi na dhihaka. Na nikasema ile nilipeana ya kwanza wawili kwamba watengeneze njia zao, maana Mungu anakuja kuwaadhibu. Na mwingine Mungu akasema, Mungu amewaambia tengenezeni njia zenu. And I mention one particular ufuno ambao imekuja kumhusu, nikaona anadhoofika kiafya. Na nitaambia that member of parliament that if Jehovah be the Lord, Jehovah who helped you, serve him. Because Mungu amekuonya, unabadilisha madhabahu. You have entered in some very funny activities that I will not mention here. I told you get a good pastor, mwenye kichwa chake ni mzuri na ana power akusaidie. Because as for me, sitakusaidia. Don't come. Na usinitafute. But there are other people who can help you. Mae ni kukuonya na kukuambia. So ni maona ufunuo ambao umeonekana. This man will die. This man is going to die. Na yeye ni moja wapo ya zile mauti ambazo zimepangana za watu wakubwa. Akimbia haraka sana. Aende afanye toba. Atengeneze njia zake. Awachane madhabahu za giza. Awache matendo za giza. Awachane nazo. Maybe Mungu atamhurumia. La sivyo, utawacha watoto wako mayatima. Na wanawake ambao umewaoa, maana ni wengi umewaoa, utawacha kama ni wajane. Someone you can check prophecy before. Na roho Bwana atakusaidia ujue ni nani huyo nimeongelea. It is a sad one. So when I tell you kwamba sometimes nalia alafu ndo nikuja hapa kuambia na vitu hizo, please believe it. When God say, mjue ukitishwa na shetani atutakufa, ai hiyo kuja hapa. Naambia shetani, wewe chunga sana Beelzebuth. Lakini kama ni Mungu mwenyewe anapeana maonyo, hata mimi naogopa. And that's why Captain Ruto ogopa sana. God has no respect for kings or captains. God has no respect of persons. Na plus watu wote ambao wanakula na kusherehekea na yeye. Ogopeni sana. Because mambo ambayo itafanyika is that according to that vision ya Ruto kushtuka na kuogopa sana. When a king, when a prince is showed to be frightened, and not any other but it's God's doing, then just know that the next thing is terrible that will happen. Na mama mba itafanyika kupitia kutokana na hali hizo, there'll be a series za tauni. Vile Farao, bae ni mfalme, alikuwa mfalme wa Misri, aligandamiza wana wa Israeli miaka hizo, na pia jinsi wana wa Israeli walikuwa katika ugandamizaji na mateso kwa miaka 400. Na ikafika kwamba walilia sana na kilio chao kikamfikia Mungu wa binguni. Ikawa kama Mungu akainua nabii Musa ili akuja mletee Farao ujumbe. Ndivyo ilivyo sasa kuhusu Kenya and maybe Africa and maybe dunia pia. Hallelujah. Sikayanto sibabo. I'm seeing you guys, you have some funny signals, and I'm wondering those signals. So jinsi Musa akainuliwa na Mungu wakati ule, ni kwamba Mungu alikuwa anafanya kufanyisha neno lake. That I will not destroy a man or a nation or a people without prior warnings. Wakristo, hata nyinyi tunaangaliana. Mungu atakuonya once, twice, thrice. Maybe anaweza kuonya even 7 times. But the day when God eventually deals with you or judgment ya Mungu ikukule, it will be upon your own head because he'll have warned you. And the same way God does with the king, the same way God does with the nation. So unapata Misri, Farao alionywa sana wakati manabii Musa. I'm here to go back to the Bible and go back to the common scriptures we've read about Moses going before Pharaoh and telling Pharaoh, let my people go. Thus says God. Thus says the Lord. I don't know how many times Pharaoh did so. And I think I should investigate in the scriptures to know that for how long, because for Jonah, the Bible tells us that was 40 days. He sang the same chorus, repeated the same stanza, that God shall judge you people. Repent or you shall die. That's what Jonah did over Nineveh. I want to go back and investigate and interrogate the scriptures again and ascertain this man, Moses, for how many months, for how many days, for how many weeks did he appear before Pharaoh with the same message, let the people of God free. Free the people of God. Let my people go. By the time God was judging Pharaoh and Egyptians, and the last stroke was death of Pharaoh's son, and for that matter, it was the only son. Just as well as, I mean, firstborns of the other, all the princes, and all they that are the top cream, plus every other person who were the inhabitants, I mean, were Egyptians at that time. They all lost their firstborns. That was the last stroke. And the people will also be eating into the judgment that the captain also will be eating. But God sends, Mungu angetumana, tauni baada ya tauni. There were 10 plagues. Just like there were 10 plagues that plagued Egypt and terrorized Pharaoh, the similar pattern is going to be repeated over the Republic of Kenya and in the administration of Captain Ruto. Plagues. God will use them to warn the man that it is I, Jehovah God, and I'm saying, change course, let go, restitute, and abandon. Holding with illegality stuff that is someone else's. 10 plagues. Maybe in our time there will not be parasites, bees, boils, the river, waters of the rivers turning into blood, dust, darkness. Maybe they will be taking a different formation. Keep your eyes open and your ears on the ground. You shall see. So today, God is showing State House stricken with the lightning that frightens, and related dreams and visions like the walls falling, walls cracking, that issue where you water from the State House, darkness in the place. Remember also there was darkness in that time. Remember also I gave a prophecy about Kenya enters darkness and gloom because of our ignorant clergy who are lovers of the world more than lovers of God. And so that one has been shown. So there will be several. So ndio nikasema maandamano hii ni mmeona. Please don't think that it was just a child play. There's no child play. Hakuna mchezo. And there will be a lot of such. Kutakuwa na maandamano tu mengi. They'll continue. And that's why I say, ni mtu tu mujinga. Ndiye ataamua kufanya kujeruhi ama kumfanya majeraha kiongozi huyo wa upinzani. Let's advise the security apparatus who are nawasaidia kama terrorists wanataka kuja Kenya nawasaidianga pia leo nawasaidia na wale ma security apparatus ambao vichwa vyenyu huwa ni iko na makasoro mnaambiwa vitu vingine mnafanya nyata hata baadaye una regret, please hapa tubu. Hiyo barabara achana, you can resign your job, because anything that is ordained of God, God himself will judge you terribly. You may die a death that was not ever ordained for you. Now, nafikanga mali penye, if you know you're a security officer and you are being like sent like a boy on errand, enda choma nyumba ya mtu na moto, enda fanya hivi na hivi. It reaches a time when if you find that that is your mission, you pull back and say no. I resign. I can resign rather than be part of something that will bring me at loggerheads with God. And I've sent that caution because I've been a helper to Kenya security apparatus on matters, terrorism and plans, anything that may threaten security. And that I have been doing since Kibaki's time. So on this one, take me serious. You can bite, you may end up biting more than you can chew. And those who are advisors of the president, this one I'm saying it in the public. Think and pray. You can never defeat the judgment of God. You can't. Allow the judgment of God to take its course. When you see it, repent by yourself. Because that repentance is for all of us. Let my people go. Let restitution take place. There will be changes. And the changes that are coming are this one. Changes that are coming are defined in the prophecies I've shared before. Of some deeds or some memorandums. The signings of some pacts that will take place. I'm not saying a handshake. It will be a signing for power. That that Captain Ruto himself shall cave in. He shall give in. To all, he shall give in to the demands. And he shall sign it. That will be the beginning of peace for some people. It will be the beginning of a little bit of rest for the nation. Ndio mwanzo wa kipindi kiasi kidogo ya amani na pumziko. But it will also be the climax of judgments, God's judgment over the leadership that is now in power. They'll be judged, all of them. They'll be judged. Just like ultimately Pharaoh caved in and surrendered to the will of God, to the demands of God, and he had to allow allow Moses and the Egyptians to go. That's the same thing. Ruto and his administration will give in. Because the battle is not Raila's. The battle is the Lord's. And God can use anybody. And so for this one, he's chosen to use Odinga. Mine is to speak what I hear and I see in the realm of the spirit, and the rest is to confirm to me what you see in the natural, the daily unfoldings. So that's why people say, "Hey, labda meangalia area." A prophet anaangalia anaonanga mbali, Mungu anakufichulia. So Pharaoh had to let baada ya kuona, "Hey, you mean I've lost my son? You mean I've lost my son? And you mean everybody's crying? And you mean all of us, we dignitaries, everybody's crying for your son? Pharaoh, we shall die. I've lost my son. I've lost my son. I've lost my son. Everybody, I've lost my son, my eldest son. Oh, Pharaoh, if you have accepted, this thing wouldn't have happened." Pharaoh eventually said, "Okay, tell that bugger." And the bugger by that time was Moses. "Take your people and go to that funny wilderness and go place your God there and go on everybody with your things. I don't want to see you." Even if he released them in anger, he released them anyway. It was against his own will, but he released them anyway. And the Jews, Bible says, and the Jews made merchandise of the Egyptians that last night, and they left with gold and with silver. And once they were beyond, and they were crossing the Red Sea, the same Red Sea that they were able to cross safely became the very, very death knell that swallowed Pharaoh's mercenaries and Egyptians that were pursuing after the Jews. And that was the last stroke. So but you can remember that by the time Pharaoh said yes, there was so much that will terrorize him. So much that will terrorize him. So much that will shake him. So much that will cause him losses. So much that will cause him a pain in his heart. So much that will pain his heart. So this government will suffer losses. They will suffer setbacks. There will be cryings. They will not sleep peacefully. They'll burn the midnight oil and replan and undo the plans and plan again. They will try everything, but they will fail because God is never defeated by the wisdom of man. That reminds me of the prophecy that we had here about what God's voice said. That even though they appear to have won the elections, lakini mimi Mungu sijamaliza. Siku moja, nitalipiza. Na Raila Odinga ataapishwa. Some people may not remember that vision and that prophecy that took place here. May not remember. But you know what? It is coming to pass. Mapenzi ya Mungu Kenya haitafanikishwa. Tell the church clergy. Tell the intercessors. Tell the prophets. Tell the apostles. Tell the remnants that the will of God for Kenya, that God, the will of God for Kenya will not be accomplished in the time of Captain Ruto. And because the agenda of God is so supreme, he must pave way. God push him aside. And God is pushing him aside. So there will be happenings, manifestations of happenings, and manifestations of circumstances. There are manifestations of stuff and things that will be pointing a finger at what God wants. That you must be out. You must be out. You must be out. You must be out. And his own cronies will tell him, boss, this thing is bad. His own closest associates and his advisors will tell him, this is bad. This battle is the finger of God. Just like Pharaoh was told by his witches and sorcerers that, hey, Pharaoh, this is the finger of God. Similarly, it will be for Captain Ruto. His own close and his advisors and the people around him will actually have pumped so much in him that this is the hand of God. God hardened Pharaoh's heart until the 10 plagues had taken place. And so he gave up after the 10 plagues. The same thing is at play. After the plagues in our day and time will have plagued Kenya at the eyes and at the sight of Captain Ruto and his cronies, when they were done, then his heart will cave in. His pride will cave in. His arrogance will cave in. will give up. That informs you the praiser's visions. Kenya, don't celebrate us yet. It's not over. No celebration yet. Shared before, the prophecies. It is not over as yet. Are we going to elections? We are going into the elections. I've not seen the elections. I've just seen the inauguration. There's no elections. There are no elections. There are no elections. The elections were won square. Rudisha mtu nyama yake achukue. Akule. Then you see how Kenya Mungu atatembea. Mtu na vile Kenya Mungu atafanya mambo zake. You see how God will do his stuff for Kenya.
And asante sana kwa kutazama Wasos TV. Kama uja subscribe na kumbu uweza kusubscribe.
Beginning of peace.
Kama kuna maoni ni achi hapo kwenye comment section. Hiyo imekuwa tu ni maoni na prophecy ya huyo some, pastor ambayo umemsikiza hapo akizungumza mambo yake.
Ndiyo mwanzo wa kipindi kiasi kidogo ya amani.
Anaona kama mchungaji. So mimi sijui una maoni gani, ni achi hapo kwenye comment section kama uja subscribe.
The climax of judgment.
Like
God's judgment
share pia ndakuwa na
shukuru over the
sana.
Leadership that
hadi
is wakati now.
Mwingine mimi nakushukuru kwa wakati wako kwa kuchagua kutazama Wasos TV. Asanteni sana na Mungu awabariki.
Thank you very much. Hapa tuko na Honorable Dr. Babu Owino, a loving husband and a responsible father, your favorite son. Leo hii tuko ndani ya Wasos TV. Stay tuned. Tibim.